What is going on, everybody? Depraved Slasher here. We are back with another Ice Nine Kills reaction. I'm Depraved.
I'm Hellcat.
And together we are
Hella Depraved.
All right. The goal is to bounce back from yesterday. Maybe.
Right. Right, right.
But
I was like, bounce back from what? And then I was like, oh, that's right. Not your favorite song, but that's okay. We got something that might...
We got something that will cheer at least us up.
Got a mighty squeal.
We seem to have gotten this evidence log.
Right.
Envelope in the mail today.
It's so cool.
And we didn't open it. The tag is still on. I was about to, and then I was like, probably should wait.
The chain of evidence has not been broken.
Oh, no, it's ripping. No. Damn you. Let go.
We'll have to fix it later. We'll have to fix it and then sign it and make sure that everyone knows that, you know, that's what they do.
Oh.
For a chain of evidence to make sure people know that it hasn't just been randomly opened.
What's this? It's heavy.
That is so pretty.
It is. It
feels nice. Ugh. I can still appreciate a really nice album look.
We pre-ordered it. It came a little late, but...
Oh, that's what is so this? Pretty. You can tell he's the squealer of the bunch. Look at all of the pictures!
This is awesome!
Evidence file. Oh my god, I love it. I love it.
We're gonna have to go through these later. I'm assuming this would come in a booklet normally.
Well, but it's supposed to be an evidence file, so it's separate pictures. They did a fantastic...
Oh, they have all the lyrics on all the pages.
You know what? This reminds me of the Pearl Jam 10 album. Because it came with a whole bunch
of... No, it's not. They're not the lyrics.
It came with a bunch of loose cards and stuff.
But they do say what all of them are based off of.
That's fantastic.
This one's Candyman. Army of Darkness.
Nice.
That is fucking fire. And they're pictures we can hang up. Like, I definitely want to hang that one up.
That's great. That's probably based off my Bloody Valentine, isn't it?
No, this was a...
Axe?
This was Hip to Be Scared.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Rainy Days.
Well, some of them, yeah.
Funeral Derangements.
That's great.
Okay. This is fantastic. This is...
Rash decision.
I am here
so pretty
for all of this. A lot of these will get hung up. We may make a little collage out of them.
Well, yeah.
And then, of course, the album itself.
Oh, and it's got the evidence tape on it, too.
That's fire. Is it actual tape? It is.
That's great.
That's fire.
And I love that they made it look like it's drawn with a Sharpie. That's fantastic.
I like that. I like that a lot.
All right.
You guys do good work. Great work.
I mean, they put a lot of money into everything. Like, production value. I don't mean... Yeah. It's fantastic. All right.
I love it.
So we're excited.
All right. So. Next up is the box. So even if I don't like this song, it's not going to ruin my day.
I really like Hellraiser. And
I kind of like Hellraiser.
Now, I understand what you say about the first one because it is chaotic. Like, it does not feel like you solidly know what the hell is going on at any point.
Right.
But I feel like when you watch that with... Hellraiser 2 and 3 pretty close together. They make a cohesive story.
It's the same thing with like
Saw.
Not even just Saw, but like talk about like older movies. Puppet Master? The Puppet Master
yeah,
series.
That too.
Like the first 3 tell an amazing story that you
but
don't
together,
really get
yeah.
unless you watch them together. So anyways, this is the box, and this is featuring Brendan Saller, Saller, and Ryan Kirby.
Okay. Atreyu.
One of these guys is from the band Atreyu.
Yeah.
I don't know where the other one's from. Our cat is jungle gymming again.
She just wakes up when we get up, basically.
She wakes up and chooses annoyance.
Or violence. It's either or.
Yeah. But anyways, super stoked for this now. So with that being said, we're going to react to this as if you guys have already seen it. If not, click the link in the description below. Hop on over, do other things, come on back. And we say that because we're a commentary, reaction, breakdown, comedy channel. What that means is we will pause for any and or all of the above.
Wonderful.
With that being said, it is time to slash it up and break it down. This is Ice Nine Kills featuring Brendan Saller and Ryan Kirby with The Box.
I'm the man
in the box.
That's all I can
That's what I think
hear of. In my brain.
And whatever. Of course, since the Merkins did the version with Hellraiser singing that song, it all ties together.
Well, and then Clove did her version.
Oh, no, I was just talking about how it ties the Hellraiser theme.
Yeah, I know, but for, she did it spooky version, too, so, you know. Anyway.
All right, let's get it. This is hell. Let's go!
Yeah.
I fucking love it.
This is fantastic. First of all, I do like Atreyu. But just the... The references, the pleasure to pain, the lament box, the thinking outside the box. I mean, like, come on now. And then, of course, his voice is beautiful on this. But, yeah, all hail your master.
I am fucking here for this. Oh.
Plus, I just like this song, even without maybe the Hellraiser.
Right.
Like, it's just a cool song.
Let's go! So somebody
fantastic.
Fucking lied.
Somebody said that this was... He might not like this because it was heavier than the last one. Is that what you were talking about?
No, I said I might not like it because I heard that it was heavier than the last one. I was watching somebody's album review and they said this was one of the heaviest songs. No, the fuck it's not.
Okay, yes, it is. It is, but not in the metalcore way. Like, it's a very heavy song. But it's not a metalcore vocal heavy, if that makes sense.
Sure.
The instrumental leads it to be a very heavy song.
Not really. If you compare it to Take Your Pick.
Right.
Take Your Pick, from the moment the song started, I knew it was going to be a rough one for me.
Yeah, but that's because of... it's hard to describe, but this is what you would consider a heavy metal song.
Right.
Like, heavy one, though. Not ballad, not...
I wouldn't consider this like heavy metal.
I know, but that's because you like it.
No. It's... I feel like what I say is heavy and what other people think is heavy are two different things.
Right, but that's because it's subjective. I'm saying, in general, when talking about metal music...
When I think of heavy metal, or more specifically metalcore...
Right.
I think of bands like Lamb of God.
Right.
Corpse Grinder.
Right.
Things like that. Which, this does not sound like that. The last song did. When I think, okay, so when I think of, and again, this is just my opinion on metal music, metalcore, heavy right. metal, whatever. When I think of metal, it just sounds like a bunch of noise. People growling, guitars all over the place, right. drums all over the place. Shit that I don't really vibe with.
Right.
I like melody and a flow. A cohesive whole. And...
Yeah, I okay, but that's only in some of their songs. Like, and I get that you obviously haven't listened to a lot of their catalog because, you know, people like what they like. So you wouldn't go down their catalog if you don't right. like the sound. This is still considered.
No, I know it's considered heavy metal, but this isn't heavy.
That's what I was saying, though. This is still considered the heavier side of heavy metal. So, like, I get what the people were saying in the review, but subjectively... The sound is amazing because you got a lot of melody. You got a lot of not just power metal type beat to keep up with. Spencer's singing really beautifully. You know, it's classification versus subjective review on it. And I love it. I mean, I like metalcore too, like sometimes. But I really like all of the little pieces of Hellraiser that are going into almost every sentence in this. It's not just like a little sprinkling of Hellraiser. He right. is very explicitly singing about it, but he made it into a song that you could listen to not having ever seen the horror movie and still
right.
enjoy the message, I guess. And I've just watched several of the Hellraisers recently, like she Judgment did. And I did. Like, I enjoy it. So, all the puzzle pieces.
I was so proud of you. You went to sleep last night watching Nightmare on Elm Street.
I did.
It was the remake. Somebody out there will be like, ew. But I appreciate it.
I like it. You know? I like all of them, though. All right. So, that's sort of a thing. Let's get back into it. Your master, your master. That he says bow to the needles and pins, and it's right after the demons and angels, because Judgment Day is the one where the angel comes down and keeps telling him they gotta return the serial killer to Earth because God works in mysterious ways. And finally Pinhead's like, you know what, sis, nah, and starts taking the pins out of his forehead and pegging her right in the middle of hers. It is so great. He's just got this like, nah, what are you going to do to me kind of attitude. Of course, like at the very end, they send it back to Earth. They're like, we can punish you. You can be human again.
Oh.
He wakes up as a homeless person in a box and he's like, what? What?
This shit's not cool.
Yeah. But I mean, like, honestly, if I were him, I would have been like, worth it. Cause she was kind of
a twat.
Yeah.
Twat.
A little twatsicle. So, anyway, this is fantastic. It reminds me a lot of Avenged Sevenfold, Hail to the King. Or Crown. It's either King or Crown. But that's what the chorus specifically reminds me of. And I really like that song, so.
Right.
This is a game. sued. You tear your soul apart. Oh my god. So well done. This is exactly what got me into metalcore in the first place, is hearing the duality. Because a lot of bands, that's kind of how they started, and then metalcore became more like a little bit more deathcore in terms of it was all growls. And you know, I have to be in the mood to just have straight growling, because honestly, a lot of the instrumental stuff that goes behind metalcore, deathcore, whatever, is fantastic. They're all very, very good musicians, just in general. But this is exactly what I look for most of the time. Like, this is why metal is my thing. This might be one of my new, like, I know that we're not kind of giving away our tier list at this point, but I have to say, this is probably really fighting for the number one spot. Like,
it's up near the top for me.
I'd say probably, oh, yeah. Yeah, it's pushing it. This is fantastic. Like, just the way it was made, the breaks that they use as punctuation. Again, super hard to do as musicians, to make everything stop just momentarily. The guitar in this was incredible. Like, you'd hear Atreyu go, and then as Spencer was going to come back in for the hook or whatever, like, the guitar would pick back up into a faster speed with the melody.
Right.
Just the way that this was written was incredible. I also really like the low growls for this. It is so fitting with the concept of dragging you to hell. And
this is a prime example of low growls I don't mind. When it's not the entirety of the thing.
Right.
And it's more to accentuate a part of the song.
Right.
Like
I said, this is what I search for, because of that dichotomy between... So a lot of times it's like Lacuna Coil. So it's Christina's beautiful voice with Andre's, like, growls. And right, it's meant to show the beauty and the kind of the beast or the ugly. Like, that's the concept that it started with.
Right.
And that's kind of what I look for. But this was a fantastic example. It was gorgeous. And very clear growls. Very clear. This was fabulous.
I'm hoping...
Yeah.
I'm hoping that I can listen to the song enough that when I see the words "the box," I don't immediately go into Alice in Chains.
That's going to be hard. And
but then again, that's trying to erase 20 or 30 years, 30 plus years of music knowledge.
That's exactly it. So good luck. Although at some point you may get the weird mashup in your brain that my brain sometimes does with stuff like that, where it's like, together. I'm the man in the all hail. You know, like, my brain does that. It's nice.
So, yeah. Fantastic fucking song.
Yeah.
Again, as always, spot on with the references and...
Oh, yeah.
Double entendres that were used.
I love that he uses the word paradox. I'm sorry. There's like there's certain things day, that I geek out on.
I'm
like,
waiting
certain words.
For a day he uses the word cyclical.
Then he would be welcoming himself to my horror story. And if he wants to do that, like, if he ever sees our reviews enough that he starts using the word cyclical all the time, you know what? I'm here for it. He would probably get, actually, maybe a squeal from me at that point. Because you squeal enough already. Exactly. And I don't, so...
And if you haven't already, buy this fantastic album. We're only... That's what I was looking at over here.
I mean,
you
honestly...
You can barely see the track list on here. So.
This is beautiful, so
we've
it's
only
worth
got
the money.
Four more songs.
That's kind of sad.
And we could stretch it out to six if we want to do the orchestral versions of songs.
Right.
We probably won't, though. We've got Fly, which features Buddy Nielsen of Senses Fail.
Right.
Next. And then Worst Vacation, and then Ex Mortis, and then Farewell to Flesh.
Okay, so Ryan Kirby, who is in this, is Fit for a King. Okay. I knew Fit for a King was in here somewhere, but I'm not that familiar with that band, whereas Atreyu, I am. So I knew that was Brandon.
And if you can spring the money, definitely get the special edition album.
Yeah.
It is totally worth getting these fantastic pictures.
And honestly, guys, there's a variety of special edition.
What track was this?
Stuff. This is 10.
10?
So, you know, go to their website, check it out. There's...
That's the picture for this one.
There's vinyls. There's all sorts of different editions. I don't know what comes with each of them, because this is the one that we were able to...
Oh, no, these are the lyrics.
To buy.
Okay.
But go and have fun. He's got new ones opening up all the time. New versions, new special editions. Honestly, most of their merch, like wearable merch, is so cool.
Do you know what the All Hail thing, when they go into that, reminds me of?
What?
All Hail Jesus Frankenstein.
Yeah, we definitely go different ways. I go Avenged Sevenfold.
I go Rob Zombie.
Yeah. I mean, like, I could do Rob Zombie, too, but...
Rob was one of my favorite music acts growing up.
Yeah, mine, too. But for some reason, I still... I think probably because that and Nightmare are my favorite Avenged Sevenfold songs. Like, I don't know. Anyway, they just killed it. That was a slam dunk. That was masterful. No pun intended.
Also, while I'm going to be absolutely giddy regardless of the rest of the songs that come on, you guys probably won't see me really in the zone until the last song of the album. But only because...
Fly.
Huh?
Because The Fly and...
Well, the last song on the album's based off of Candyman.
Which is one of our favorites.
One of my favorite movies. I'm not the hugest fan of Army of Darkness. I'm not the hugest fan of Fly. And I'm kind of a fan, not really, not near as much as you, for Hostel.
Right. I'm so excited about that one. Although, like, our comment section has been filled. Everybody loves all of them, but Ex Mortis, I've
heard is really good.
Yeah, so... Again, we're not like...
But I just mean in terms of being able to catch references, right. Audio cues, vision, you know.
But we know the rest of them. Like, it's right. Not like one of those that we haven't seen that horror movie at all. It's like The Fly, I think I've seen twice.
But I will say that is probably why the first album is going to be so hard to beat for me.
You had seen each and every one of them.
Almost every single movie I absolutely adore. Except for like one.
Yeah. Same here.
And I knew all the references that were made. I caught all the audio cues from all the different movies that were used and all the nuances.
I think you'll be surprised because you've seen them more than once, and Hostel is another one of those ones that I fall asleep to. Not like fall asleep because I'm bored, but like fall asleep because I've seen it so many times.
Right.
Yeah.
All right. So with that being said, if you guys... Oh, yeah, I'm wearing my Slasher hoodie. That says
This one's fabulous.
It says Crown Royal, and it's a bunch of Slasher people
holding
Crown Royal
bottle.
Bells. This is
happy water for grumpy people.
Yes.
That was your
and
Christmas
of course,
present last year?
My favorite movie of all time.
That's a fantastic one. Dream Warriors, guys.
Huh?
I said Dream Warriors, guys.
Three more years?
Dream Warriors. Oh. You deaf man.
I've got headphones on. I was going to say three more years for what? Because, like, I need Halloween. You to live
Halloween.
A lot longer than just three more years.
Yeah, no.
All right. So with that being said, if you guys like the video, slash that like button, subscribe, ring the bells for notifications, comment down below. What did you think of Ice Nine Kills featuring, I already closed,
Brandon.
I closed the window, Brandon and Sawyer and Ryan Kirby.
Yes.
This was the box. Also, comment down below if there's anything else you guys want to see reacted to, check the description below for all the things.
Push our buttons, come join us on our other social media platforms, mostly Twitter if you want a quicker response.
With that being said, we love you guys. Thank you all for watching, and I cannot wait to see you to pray people later. I don't know what the was for, but
I have no idea.